I literally just got my hands on Bard, like right now, and stopped what I was doing so I could try it out right away. And of course, I'm taking you with me. So come on, let's jump inside Google Bard. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodian. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and enough Google content that you'd think I have a stake in the company. Spoiler alert, I do not. Today, we're going to learn how to use Bard. So let's go. And by the way, if you're wondering, what is Google Bard? Please go watch my other video on just that and then come back here and we'll actually jump inside Bard. But in short, Bard is Google's conversational AI service powered by Lambda. But enough with the chit chat, let's jump in to learn how to use Bard, complete with a few examples. When you first use Bard, you will agree to Google's terms and privacy statement that covers things like how your data is used, how long your data is stored for, as well as some important things to know about how this technology works. So once you agree to those terms, a pop-up will appear telling you that Bard may sometimes give inaccurate responses and that it's aiming to get better with your feedback. This is important to keep in mind, along with the fact that it's pulling in and analyzing data from across the internet. It is a true large language model, but just think about how powerful Bard can be since it's created by, well, Google. But with that said, let's learn how to use Bard. Obviously, you can ask Bard basic questions, but let's start with a more complex example. And all we have to do is type in our prompt at the bottom of the screen. Let's ask Bard to write a song lyric for us. Can you write a love song in the style of Taylor Swift? Enter. Okay, so this took about 5 seconds to generate a song for us, but let's actually see how well Bard did. Like, this chorus doesn't really rhyme and verse 2 is a little wordy, to say the least. And this bridge? I can't imagine my life without you. You're my best friend, my lover, my soulmate, and I love you more than anything in the world. This is definitely not a Taylor Swift bridge. It seems like this is more like Bard is pulling sappy love letters from the internet. So it's safe to say we're not gonna win any Grammys with this song, but you get the idea here of how it's composing a song and how it's generating responses in general. Plus, if you don't like this version of the song or what Bard has given you, you can click on View Other Drafts in the top right, and you'll be able to pull up alternative responses. Just click on an alternative response to view it. So you could use this same method to write plays and stories, or write essays or blog posts, create job descriptions or job applications, compose marketing emails, and the list goes on and on. So let's go through some other things Bard can do. Something that would be helpful to have is Bard write an email newsletter promoting my latest YouTube video on Bard. So here is my prompt explaining the video is about how to use Bard, and we'll hit enter and see how it does. All right, here we go. It's given me an email subject line and the email starts out good enough, though it does start to repeat itself in the third paragraph here. So remember, we can view other drafts. So I will pick this second draft to review it. It's got a different subject line and it has not repeated itself. I actually like this one better. So Bard has done most of the work for me here. So of course, I can now copy this over and paste it where I want it and tweak it how I see fit. So say you wanted to take bits and pieces of each draft and copy them out. There are actually a couple of different ways that you can copy out of Bard. First, you can select the text you want to copy and then carry on with your regular copy and paste. Or you can click on the three-dot menu icon in the bottom right of the chat and copy the entire response. And stay tuned for why it's going to be important for you to copy out your responses while you have them. But now, naturally, let's get Bard to write additional social media posts promoting this video that you're watching right now. We're inside the AI universe? Anyway, let's ask it to use this same style, but in a tweet. Using this style, promote this video in a tweet. And would you look at that? My tweet is written. Just released a new video on how to use Bard. In this video, I show you how to generate text, translate languages, write different kinds of creative content, and answer your questions in an informative way. Check it out. This is actually a really good promo tweet, so I'm gonna copy that to use it to promote this video. Just changing a little bit of the text and the hashtags to better suit my needs. And I'm guessing I can do the same thing if I want to promote it on Facebook. So now write a Facebook post promoting this video. Okay, so this is interesting here. It's written a little Facebook promo, but underneath that, it's added some tips on how to write a Facebook post that will promote my latest YouTube video. So you can tell Bard is pulling from Google as if someone had searched for how to write a Facebook post promoting my latest YouTube video. So these are cool writing examples, but what else could you do with Bard? Well, as Bard kind of told us in our last example, you can do other things like translate languages. So let's give this a try. How do you say, "I love you, ain't that the worst thing you ever heard?" That's for you, my fellow Swifties, in Italian. And just like that, a translation is generated, which is unsurprising given that Google Translate has been a go-to staple in my life since its inception. But how do we know how accurate this translation actually is? Because to be fair, I got different responses every time I asked Bard. So I asked a cousin of mine from Italy to tell me how good of a job Bard did with this translation. And her translation was a little bit different than what Bard provided me. However, she did say that she did understand Bard's initial translation. So I would say it's very similar to how Google Translate works in that it may not be exactly accurate, but you're getting your overall message across. And not to have you do all of your homework and assignments using Bard, you could have it solve math problems for you, and yes, it shows its work. All right, so a real estate agent received a 6% commission on the selling price of a house. If his commission was $8,880, what is the selling price of the house? Boom. Bard shows exactly how to solve the problem with the correct answer. Trust me, I double checked. Which, in fairness, isn't saying much because math is not my strong suit, but now I don't have to be good at math. But in all seriousness, if I had Bard around while I was in school, ooh, well, maybe I shouldn't even think about that. So stay in school and do your homework, kids. But with that said, there are a few things in the Bard interface that are really good to know. The left side features your main menu. You can click on the hamburger icon in the top left to collapse or expand the menu. Right underneath that is the option to reset the chat. I like having the chat history here, but it's up to you if you want a fresh page for a new query. And remember, there's something very important to note about your chat history. When you close out of your Bard tab and head back to Bard again at another time, you'll notice your chat has been reset. Don't freak out if you wanted your history. You'll actually head to Bard Activity on the left. If you click on that, a new activity tab opens up where you can choose whether Bard stores your activity. So here's where you turn that off if you don't want your queries stored. But under that, you'll have all of your activity and queries organized per date. But just so you know, as of right now, only queries are saved, not the responses generated. So if you're using Bard and you like a response, you better copy that out before you close your tab. You got it? So at least every query is saved for you, but it's just found in this tab instead. And again, the responses to the queries are not saved. Now you can delete individual queries from here too, or delete a custom date range of activity. Back in our Bard dashboard in the top right, you'll notice your Google account profile, and beside that is the all familiar Google Apps access. So you can pop right over to your Gmail, Gcal, Drive, or whatever you want right from here. Now, in the chat section, there are a couple of other features to be aware of. Remember, Google wants feedback on answers it's providing, so you can like or dislike a response. And remember how we can view other drafts of responses? Well, you also have the option to generate a new response entirely. And by the way, generating a new response and viewing other drafts only seems available on that most recent response. So if we scroll up through the older responses, those two options are gone. Last, there is a Google It button on, for some reason, only some of my responses. So this is really handy if you want to double check the response Bard has given you. You can literally click to Google it. Here, a related search query appears, and if you click on a search topic from those queries, a new Google Search Results tab will open up where that search query is automatically applied for you. And we can see that yes, indeed, this answer is correct. But back in Bard, it's also worth noting that in your chat, you can click on the edit button to edit your query. So at this point, you may be wondering how to get access to Bard. Well, as of March 21st, Google has rolled out their waitlist in the US and the UK. Right now, it is still in its experimental phase. So they really want a closed group of people to test it first before publicly releasing it. With that said, to get on the waitlist, head to bard.google.com and click on Join Waitlist. From there, you'll sign into your Google account if you're not signed in already. And by the way, I was on the waitlist for just a few hours, for real. And then I got access. Once you're greenlit to access Bard, you're gonna head to that same spot, bard.google.com. And yes, I've included the link in the description below for you. Plus, I'm definitely making a video comparing ChatGPT capabilities to Bard. So if you're interested in that, drop a comment below. Until then, I'm off to chat with my new AI counterpart. So that's how to use Bard. What do you think of Bard? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more content just like this. You know you wanna. Thanks for watching. See you next time.